Welcome back to another unboxing video, and this time I have for you Star Wars The Clone Wars by Z-Man. It is a Pandemic System game, and I gotta be honest, this one caught me off guard. I think it caught a lot of people off guard. Kind of was a surprise announcement, and was pretty happy to get my hands on it as quickly as possible. I know this is an unboxing video, but I can't help but say I'm once again disappointed in Target and their shipping. I don't know if you can see that, but that corner got dinged up. This has got a rip in it. I know it's just a game, but I'm getting tired of getting damaged things being shipped to me. Let's get into the unboxing though. So we take a look here. Beautiful artwork on here. I love the look of the box. I'm very excited to get this to the table. When we open it up, got the rule book, and quick look through it already. Once it looks like it's pretty much laid out like the classic Pandemic game, and I thought they did a pretty nice job of explaining the rules in that game, so I think this will be done just as well. We've got the planet map, and already started that, so we can take a look at it. My initial instinct on it, I have a slight disappointment with it. We've got our invasion track here, which is going to come into play, obviously. It'll tell us how many cards we have to put out. I don't know if I'm going to be able to open the whole thing here on camera, but we can see a good portion of it. Sorry for the glare. What I'm a little bit disappointed on, I realize they're working with space limitations, table limitations, but I was really hoping, you know, Pandemic itself, you have a world map. I was really hoping that this would be a little more, I don't know if you can say accurate, that would be tough to do for a Star Wars galaxy map, but this just, it feels very simplistic. And I know, again, they're trying to condense it into table space availability, but I would have liked a little bit more. Now I will tell you, I did look up these planets, and they are at least in close proximity to each other. Not exactly the way it shows on the map, but at least they did think that part through. And as a Star Wars fan, that I could see other people being upset about that too. You know, quite honestly, let's be honest here, Coruscant should be more in the center of the map. But that's a discussion for another time. Now, when we get into this a little further, we've got the minis here. And they look decent. I'll pull out one of my favorites, Darth Maul. I'll just take a close-up look at him. Let's see how close we can get and not lose focus. I mean, I think the detailing is pretty neat. I do like painting my minis. I probably will get some paint on these. I'm a little nervous about doing them because I want them to be screen accurate, of course. I am an old Wizards of the Coast minis player, and it's losing focus again. Sorry about that. There we go. And while these lightsabers are a bit more to scale than the Wizards of the Coast games used to be, those were a lot fatter, I am a little bit nervous. These are, I don't want to say fragile, but they certainly could snap off if you're not careful. Fortunately, they do have a nice box here that they do slide into pretty well. They hold pretty tight. But of course, then that brings up that question. If I paint them, will the paint chip off? So let's see if we can get that in focus again. But you can see our Jedi in there, and we have our enemies as well. And I'm curious how those play out. I've never played anything beyond just the basic Pandemic. Getting into the cards here, oops, looks like we have our, these are the individual cards for the villains, if I remember right, and each of them will have a planet under siege, which basically is like your Pandemic when the planet pops, for lack of a better word. We have the planet cards. I assume that the Jedi cards are in here as well, seeing in this stack here. Oh, this one looks like it'll open up pretty easily, so let's get that open. It's always a lot of fun listening to the cellophane come off, I know. But we got our planets, And I do like that they at least give you some idea where to find them on the map, on the solar system there. And then we do have our, I forget what they call these, but these would be our allies and our squad cards. That's what it was. Squad cards that you can use in the game. And yeah, the artwork's pretty decent. And then we get into the Jedi cards here. And each of the Jedi have their own special abilities. And they come with their own reference cards as well. And yeah, they look pretty good. Not much else you can say about that. We get in here, then we've got our villain cards. They are double-sided. And my understanding is that they start on one side, and then when you've done enough missions, depending on the difficulty, then you switch over to the finale. And you've got your four different villains here that you can use. And I'm curious how they play. And like I said, I haven't done a Pandemic game that has characters like this. I'm just used to the basic Pandemic. Now, according to the rule book, there should be more. So don't give up on the box. There's still something in here. Because you can't have Pandemic without something to populate the planets. And I gotta say, I was pretty happy that they actually did droids. I was worried it was just gonna be cubes. Nothing wrong with the cubes in Pandemic, but this is a nice little addition to it. And I am actually just now noticing for the first time they even took the time to give you different sculpts. I mean, you got a couple some kneeling, you got some running droids, you've got some standing droids. Looks like we have a droid commander in there as well. So I like that. These guys, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to paint them. These may just be a spray paint job and throw a light wash on them and call them done. They're a little bit small for my eyes. We also have in here our blockades. This is what happens, I guess, when the planets pop. And then we've got a die, which I'm not used to in Pandemic, but looks like you can do damage and take damage on that. And then we've got some markers, and these are decent. They're not cardboard. Nice solid markers, couple clear markers. I believe these are mission markers. Not exactly sure what these two are. I know one of them is, I saw something about it being a solo marker, so when you're playing solo. But there we go. That's Pandemic. I'm sorry, not Pandemic, but Star Wars Pandemic by Z-Man. And I'm looking forward to giving it a shot. You may, in fact, throw it on the table as soon as I upload this video. If you like what you see, make sure you subscribe, leave a comment down below, and until next time, keep gaming.